What's up everyone, in this video we are going to look at a complete and in-depth way to stabilize camera in a cheap Steadicam. So first of all, the thing about this Steadicam is that it works on the basis of physics, so it is always try like that. So you need to try a lot to stabilize the camera on a Steadicam, especially on a cheap one, because the way to stabilize camera in cheap Steadicam is little bit difficult. So this video we are going to look at that. First we will look into the way to mount camera on your Steadicam. So if you got a quick release plate, then you can mount the quick release plate on your base plate in a center way. And if you don't have a quick release plate, then you want to mount your camera directly to this base plate. Before you start to mount your camera onto Steadicam, some things to remember. As I said, this Steadicam works on the basis of physics. So every weight of your camera matters. So remove the strap of your camera, because if you got a strap, then the weight will shift because of the strap. So you want to remove your strap. And if you got a tilting screen, just tilt the way you want to see your monitor after you set it up on your Steadicam. But I prefer you guys just don't tilt the screen, just keep it in the same place. Then set the focal length that you are going to shoot with, because if you change your focal length, then the weight of your camera will shift, which will in turn affect the stabilization. So choose the focal length that you are going to shoot with. And the last and the simple thing is that if you got battery from different brands, then if you switch the battery after stabilizing the camera, then you might need to re-stabilize the camera on the Steadicam, because the small minute weight shift from the battery from different brands will affect the stabilization of your Steadicam. So choose the battery you want to go with this camera. Next, to mount your camera to Steadicam, so find the center of gravity of your camera. If you got mirrorless camera or weightless camera setup, then you don't want to do that. But if you got like above 1 kg camera, that is with the lens and everything, the weight is little bit heavy, then you want to find the center of gravity of your camera. Just put your camera over your index finger and find the perfect center of gravity. Find the point where the camera will balance on your index finger. So after finding the point, mount the camera to your Steadicam in a way that the point that you just found out lies with the center pole of your Steadicam. So after attaching the camera to your Steadicam, we need to stabilize this Steadicam. So there is two places that we need to stabilize. First one is the tail section, then the second one is the head section. First we will look into the tail section. So on your tail section, if you don't have any weight, then your entire setup will flip over. So we need to add weight to the tail section. Either we can add the physical weight that it comes with, or you can extend the center pole of your Steadicam. Both will do the same job, that is it will add the weight to the tail section so that your setup won't flip over. At the tail section, you can extend or move the place you add the tail section, that you can extend it like wings, or you can just compress it. The use of this simple thing is that if you extend, then you will have more balance of your Steadicam, but it does come with the demerits, that is the chance of this tail section hitting your body increases. So you want to keep that in mind. Now for the drop test, which is the basic test of the Steadicam. Just keep your Steadicam horizontally and release it and count the time it will take to reach the vertical position. You can control the drop time by controlling the weight at the tail section. If you increase the weight by adding physical weight or by extending the center pole, then the drop time will decrease. And if you reduce the weight, then the drop time will increase. I made a separate video about this drop time and significance of this drop time. I prefer you guys to watch that video, because it will give you guys more detail about this drop time and it will help you to set the preferred drop time for your Steadicam and your configuration. Just remember that the drop time will differ on different camera, different steady cam, and different type of shooting mode that you want. So just keep that all in mind. So after configuring the drop time, we can move to edge section. By stabilizing the edge section, we are stabilizing the pan and tilt, that is the x axis and y axis. So to stabilize the x axis and y axis, place your steady cam in a flat surface. Make sure that you are not placing it in a tilted way or in a tilted surface. If you place your steady cam in a tilted position and if you pick up your steady cam, then your steady cam will be in a tilted position and the chance of you getting a perfect reading is very less. So keep your steady cam in a nice plane surface. And to stabilize camera in x-axis, we use the 4 knob present at the bottom of your steady cam's head. And to stabilize the camera in y-axis, we use the 4 knob present at the side of the edge section. And to stabilize camera in y-axis, there is another way. You can extend the center pole and you can decrease the length of the center pole to stabilize the y-axis, but I don't prefer you guys to do that because it will then affect the drop time and all the thing that you've done to the bottom section. So I don't prefer you guys to do that. Just use this 4 knob to balance the y-axis. So to balance the camera, just place the steady cam in a flat surface and just pick up the steady cam and check whether your steady cam is tilting to any position or panning to any position. Just check that. And if the steady cam is panning to any of the side, just place the steady cam to the flat surface again. Remove the 4 knob and move your base plate to the opposite side where the steady cam is tilting. And after that, tighten it again and check whether that fixed or not. Do the same step till your steady cam don't pan or tilt to any of the side, and voila, you have successfully balanced your camera on your steady cam. The last portion of fine tuning your x axis and y axis is going to be very difficult, and there is no easy way to do that. Just practice, practice, practice and find the position. And if you want to make that step easy, just after finding the perfect position for your steady cam from your setup, just mark a point on your steady cam so that on your next time you can just place the camera in that same position that you mark. So that's all about this in-depth way to stabilize camera in your steady cam. I know it's a little bit long, but I tried to cover all the things related to stabilizing camera onto a steady cam from my experience, and I hope you guys find this video useful. I really hope so. So that's all about this video, guys. Thanks for watching. Talk to you next one, and don't forget to subscribe.